All right, here we are. I am driving home. Episode 2 of Dashcam Confessional, hashtag Chad's Life Lessons. Let's get the one thing out of the way that I don't want to give any more recognition to, but that's beret gate. I did not wear a beret. I posted a quick video talking about that. I will give proof about that maybe on Monday. It's Friday now, so you guys will have to go the weekend without seeing my pretty face. So there's that. So beret gate, let's let it go to bed. Now I just got to make sure my mic was right. I just recorded this whole thing and my mic was like underneath my seatbelt. So all you heard was like being interviewed by Charlie Brown's mom. Let's get to the topic at hand. The hashtag Chad's Life Lesson this morning was take advantage of those stolen moments. Now, sometimes we're always looking for the big wow. This is, of course, all my opinion. But we're always looking for this big, exciting thing to happen all the time. It doesn't always happen. However, what does happen is life along the way will give you these little perfect moments. And they might only last a couple seconds. They might last 10 minutes. But they're there. And you've got to look for them, take advantage of them, and then remember them. And that's what we're calling stolen moments. So they're unexpected awesomeness, I guess is what I'm trying to say. Now, you could be going through your day, and I got a couple good examples of this. Number one, as a parent, you're going to hear me tell lots of stories about my kids, so get used to this, okay? Tough. It's my perspective. It's my show. Yesterday, I've got a 2.5-year-old, Alex. He's hilarious, but he is also a lot of work, and he can be a bit of a piece of crap sometimes. Anyways, his mom and his sister, who's 9 months old and a sweetheart, but that's my perspective as well, went out for a walk, and so it was Alex and I hanging out together, and sometimes he can be a handful. However, in this case, he was awesome. We sat and we talked about his day, and I asked how his day was, and he was always, it was good. He's super cute when you hear him say that. We made videos together. You guys saw some of them that I posted yesterday. And we laughed a lot. And then he sat and cuddled on my lap. And he's got this puppy blankie. And we watched Curious George on my phone. So it was one of those unexpected awesomeness moments. Didn't see it coming. Another example is the other day teaching in class. And I was given, those of you guys who have been in my class, I give a lot of worksheets out so you guys can do a lot of practice. So guys were practicing. Then there's conversations going. The class was getting loud and kind of obnoxious, but cool in the same time because everybody was talking about the work, but still having a good time. And I just looked out at the class and it was one of those awesomeness moments. So what I'm saying is look for awesomeness in the unexpected. We don't always have to think that we're going to be going to the old P&E. When I was a kid, the big deal was couldn't wait to go to the P&E, couldn't wait to go to a movie. Those were going to be the awesomeness things ever. And so we're always looking forward to the next big thing, right? And I think we do this in life. We're always looking for the next big thing. Well, you know what? Sometimes life's going to throw some little awesomenesses at you. And because we're sitting there looking for the next big thing or not being present in the moment, we miss them. So I'm sure you guys have known what I'm talking about. There's times where you're probably with your buddies and you're just having an awesome time and just laughing your head off and feeling good about things. That's an awesome moment. That's a stolen moment. We call them stolen moments because life comes along and we just steal these awesome moments from it. So that's basically what I wanted to talk about. This is now sitting at about 3.5 minutes, so it's a little longer than I was hoping for, but you get to see me for that little extra bit. So it is Friday, which means I'm on my way home, and which means that you will not be seeing one of these tomorrow or Sunday because Joni would kill me if I'm sitting there working on podcast stuff. She thinks it's goofy as it is. So we will leave it at that. Leslie, I'm sorry that I'm now talking directly at the camera. I know you think I'm driving and videotaping and that scares you. I'm okay. We're at a stoplight. All right. So that's all I got to say about that. I will see you guys on Monday. And that's, I guess that's that. I mean, how many times can I say that's that? That's all, folks. Okay. See you later. Peace.